We're going to start in meditation tonight. So you can either come to seated or you can be lying down. It's your choice. But remembering that the point of meditation is to awaken to the present moment, not to fall asleep. So if lying down, you're gonna get too cozy and drift off, I would suggest that you come to seated. So if you're seated, let your sit bones root down into the mat. Maybe you cross your legs, and your hands rest on your thighs. Let your shoulders fall away from your ears. Maybe you close your eyes, maybe you find a soft spot on the ground, the floor in front of you that you can look at. And take a breath in and a breath out. And just settle into stillness. You begin to notice the breath. You notice the sensations. You notice the thoughts. You notice what's alive for you in this moment. Hi, Renee. And if you're just joining us, we're starting out in meditation, either seated or lying down. Right, and the mind is designed to wander, right, and come out of the present moment. So when you notice that you're drifting into thought, into a story, into a narrative, you come back. And you come back to your breath, to the anchor of sound or sensation. You come back with kindness and compassion. You know, even though things have slowed down, and you may be working from home, you may not be working, you're at home, you're not in your regular routine, that doesn't mean that the mind hasn't gone into overdrive. And so part of mindfulness meditation is knowing when our mind goes into overdrive, noticing the thoughts, and then tapping back into the moment. Hey, Dina. Right, and so that moment Sometimes we have to come back to it over and over and over again. And that's the practice. Notice, get curious about what comes up in the stillness, right? Is it the fact that you're still? Is there resistance to getting quiet and trusting? Right, stillness allows us to meet parts of ourselves, maybe that we've never met, or maybe that we haven't gotten to know in a long time. And you just notice. And you say hello to those feelings or sensations, that resistance. In and you breathe out. Still and know that there is a quietness inside of you. And that learning to tap into that stillness, there is a wealth of wisdom. Start to deepen your breath. Maybe you place a hand on your heart, a hand on your belly. Feel the chest rise and fall. Paying attention to your breath, maybe in a way that you haven't yet today. If you're lying on your back, start to bring some movement into your body. Maybe you roll your ankles, roll your wrists. Maybe you do a full body stretch. If you're seated, maybe your arms reach up overhead. Roll your wrists. And you're going to make your way into child's pose. So in child's pose, your knees are going to be wide at the edges of the mat. Hips are going to sink back towards your heels. Fingertips are going to be reaching over in front of you on the mat. Forehead rests on the mat. Right, this place, this pose, child's pose, is a place to get grounded. It's a place to come into stillness. It's a place to come back to your breath. Right, it's a place to notice. And so you just breathe. And here, and you notice what comes up in this space. So I have been reading in the mornings, and I'm reading this book called Untamed by Glennon Doyle. And I thought this was pretty relevant. So we'll kind of work through it today as we move through practice. And as you're in child's pose, pay attention to your breath, to the inhales and the exhales. Be still and know. I read that verse many times before, but it struck me freshly this time. It didn't say pull your friends and know, or read books by experts and know, or scour the internet and know. It suggested a different approach to knowing. Just stop. Stop moving, stop talking, stop searching. Stop panicking, stop flailing. If you just stop doing, you'll start knowing. Sometimes that we don't know what we don't know the voice inside of us because we are so busy moving that we can't be still. Right? So it is in the getting still that we get to know. And I think in this time that we're in, being still and knowing that it's going to be okay eventually. We'll go back to a new normal. So walk your fingertips forward. Tuck your toes, lift your hips, and make your way into downward facing dog. Right, and part of this practice on the mat is getting to know, right? It's getting to know your body. It's getting to be able to move from a space of knowing and stillness, right? Which seems like a contradiction that there's stillness while we're moving, right? But we can still the mind. So in downward facing dog, you pedal out your feet. Right, maybe you shift back and forth to plank. You know that the width of your downward facing dog is correct if you can move back and forth into plank without moving your hands and feet. Just a little insider tip there, right? So in downward facing dog, the hands are strong, the heels are moving energetically towards the mat. There can be a slight bend in your knee. You're gonna take a full breath in, and a long breath out, and then you're gonna walk slowly to the top of your mat. So that can be, I don't know, 20 steps, it can be 2 steps, it can be somewhere in between. You could hoist your feet up there, right? However you need to get to the top of your mat, that's where you land. Feet are hip bone distance. Halfway lift on an inhale, so the spine is long, the crown of the head's reaching towards the front of the room, whatever room you're in, right? Fingertips can be on the shins, on the mat. Exhale, you fold. Do that again. Halfway lift on an inhale, spine is long. Exhale, you empty out and fold forward. Inhale, you're gonna ground down, rise to standing. Arms are gonna reach up overhead, and you're gonna interlace all of your fingers except for your index fingers. So some of you out there will remember Charlie's Angels. Right? I'm dating myself a little bit. Right? So you're making that Charlie's Angels. Arms are reaching up overhead. Take a breath in, ground down into your feet on the inhale and the exhale. You're gonna lean over towards the right, keeping your ears between your arms. Feel the stretch on the left side body, grounding down evenly into both feet. Take a breath in, you come back to center. Exhale, you're gonna lean over to the left. Take a breath in. You come back to center, unclasp the hands, reach up, look up. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you ground down into your feet and rise to standing. Interlace all but the index fingers. Inhale, you lengthen up, reaching your hands towards the ceiling. Exhale, you lean over to the left again. Take a breath in, come back to center. Exhale, you lean over to the right. If you've downloaded the playlist, you might want to start that now. I forgot about that. Take a breath in, you come back to center. Unclasp the hands, reach up, look up. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold forward. You're going to plant your hands and you're going to step back to downward facing dog. And downward facing dog, you pause, you get still, you notice the thoughts, you notice the body, you notice the breath. This seems like magical nonsense, but desperate women take desperate measures. I decided to experiment, and after the kids left for school, I shut myself in the closet, sat down on a towel, closed my eyes, and did nothing but breathe. You breathe in, you breathe out. Your next inhale, you're gonna glide forward to high plank. So you can absolutely drop the knees down to the mat. So in high plank, your shoulders are stacked over your wrists. You're up on the balls of your feet. Thigh bones are lifting up towards the ceiling. Right, the gaze is right past the edge of your mat. Right, and you be still here, and you know that this pose, right, though it may be challenging and it may bring up resistance, it will make you stronger and it won't last forever. So you take a breath in and a breath out. On your next exhale, you push back to downward facing dog. You take a breath in and a breath out. Inhale, you glide forward to high plank. You pause here. At first, each 10-minute session felt 10 hours long. I checked my phone every few minutes, planned my grocery list, and mentally redecorated my living room. The only things I seemed to know on that floor were that I was hungry and itchy and suddenly desperate to fold laundry and reorganize my pantry. So maybe you drift off into thought. Take a breath in, exhale, downward facing dog. One more inhale, you glide forward, high plank. Really hug the belly button into the spine. Push the hands down away from the mat. Spread the fingertips. Beautiful. Are you breathing? Great. Take a breath in. This time on the exhale, you're gonna lower all the way down to the mat. Body hits the mat in one piece. Take a breath in, heart lifts to cobra, so it's a teeny tiny back bend. Shoulders roll onto the back. Exhale, you lower. Inhale, the heart lifts to cobra. So the hands are light, the core is what's lifting you up. Tops of the feet are pressing down into the mat. Exhale, you lower down. One more. Inhale, the heart lifts to cobra. Exhale, you push back to downward facing dog. And in downward facing dog, you pause and you notice. When you find the urge to move, can you breathe into stillness? And know that this moment is where you are. I was an input junkie thrown into detox. I was tempted to quit every second, but I was stern with myself. 10 minutes a day is not too long to spend finding yourself, Glennon. For God's sakes, you spend 80 minutes a day finding your keys. Take a breath in and a breath out. Look forward, walk your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you empty out and fold. Inhale, you ground down, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold. Halfway lift on an in-breath. Exhale, you plant your hands, you step back to plank and you pause. You take a full breath in. Exhale, lower down to the mat. Heart lifts on an inhale to cobra. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. Take a breath in and a breath out. Look forward, walk, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you ground down, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you plant your hands, you step back to plank, you pause. You take a breath in. Exhale, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. All right, and as you breathe and you move, where can you find stillness, right? Maybe it's the breath, right? Smooth out the edges. Maybe it's the mind. Take a breath in, look forward, walk, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on a breath in. Exhale, you plant your hands, you step back to plank, and you pause. Take a breath in. Exhale, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on your in breath. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, you take a breath in and a breath out, and you pause and you get still and you notice. You get curious about the parts of yourself that you meet here. You can stay in downward facing dog, or you can drop into child's pose. After a few weeks, like a gymnast who's able to stretch deeper after each training, I began to feel myself dropping lower during each closet session. Eventually, I sank deep enough to find a new level inside me that I never known existed. This place is underneath, low, deep, quiet, still. There are no voices there, not even my own. All I can hear down there is my breath. As though I've been drowning in my panic, and I had been gasping for air, calling for rescue, and flailing on the surface. What I really needed to do to save myself was let myself sink. It struck me that this is why we say to people, calm down, because beneath the noise of the pounding, swirling surf is a place where all is quiet and clear. It is the sinking into stillness that we come to know. Walk the fingertips forward, tuck the toes, lift the hips, downward facing dog. Take a breath in. Right leg is going to lift to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you're going to place it in between the hands. So you're in a low lunge. So the right knee stacked over the right ankle. You're on the ball of the left foot. Fingertips can be down to the mat. They can be hovering or they can be on a block or any sort of prop that you may have. Spine is long. Crown of the head's reaching towards the front of the room. Right, and here in this stillness, what do you notice? What do you know? What do you know to be true? Take a breath in and a breath out. Your left foot's gonna step up to meet the right. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you empty out and fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Interlace all but the index fingers. Ground down, arms reach up overhead. Exhale, lean over towards the right. Draw the fingertips towards the right side of the room. Take a breath in, you come back to center. Exhale, you draw the fingertips towards the left side of the room. Take a breath in. And a breath out. Inhale, you come back to center. Uncross your fingertips. Boy, I just lost the word right there. Look up, exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you plant your hands, you step back to plank. You move through vinyasa, right? So that vinyasa is the lowering down, the moving into cobra, and making your way back to downward facing dog. So you can skip that whole thing altogether and just go back to downward facing dog. Take a breath in, left leg lifts to the sky. Exhale, step the left foot in between the hands. You're in a low lunge. So you can drop the right knee to the mat, or you can keep it lifted. So that right thigh bone's lifting up towards the ceiling. Beautiful, take a breath in and a breath out. Keep that left knee bending forward. Do you want your left thigh parallel to the mat? Take a breath in, and on the exhale, the right foot steps up to meet, the right foot steps up to meet the left. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Interlace all but the index fingers. Ground down on an inhale. Exhale, you drag the fingers towards the right side of the room. Inhale, you come back to center. Exhale, you move towards the left. Beautiful. Inhale, you come back to center. Unclasp the hands. Look up. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold, you plant your hands, you step back to plank, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on an inhale, and exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. Take a breath in and a breath out. On your next inhale, right leg lifts to the sky. Exhale, you step it forward in between the hands. You're in a low lunge. This time the left hand's gonna stay down, the right hand's gonna lift up. You're gonna open up. Low lunge twist. Take a breath in and a breath out. Right hand's gonna come down to the mat. Left foot's gonna step up to meet the right. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Exhale, you bend the knees, you sit the hips back, chair. So in chair, you're gonna reach your arms up overhead. You're gonna interlace all but the index fingers. Keep the heart lifted. Beautiful. You notice what comes up here. What part of yourself do you meet? Where can you find stillness? Breathe in. Take a breath in and a breath out. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold, plant your hands, move through vinyasa. From downward facing dog, you take a breath in and a breath out. Notice your mind. Left leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it forward in between your hands, low lunge. You're strong in your feet. Your feet are in two separate lanes. Right hand stays down, left hand lifts up, low lunge twist. Stack that left shoulder over the right. Open up the heart. Beautiful. Take a breath in and a breath out. Right foot steps up to meet the left. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you ground down and rise to standing. Interlace all but the index fingers, and on the exhale, you bend the knees, you sit the hips back to chair. Right, so in chair, the weight's on the back side of your body. Right. Know that the body's got you. Nobody's legs have ever fallen off in chair. I mean, I know it's strange times, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Right, so the knees are stacked over the ankles, the heart's lifted. You breathe in, you breathe out. Exhale, you fold forward. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold, you plant your hands, you step back to plank. You take a breath in and a breath out. Your next exhale, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on an inhale. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. Be still and know that it will be okay, that you are okay, even in downward facing dog. Take a breath in and a breath out. Right leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it forward in between the hands. Left hand stays down, right hand comes up, low lunge twist. On the inhale, the spine gets long. On the exhale, can you open up the heart a little bit more? Beautiful, take a breath in. Right hand comes down. This time you're gonna rise to high crescent lunge. So arms reach up overhead. Right knee stacked over the right ankle. Left thigh bones lifting up towards the ceiling. Belly button's hugging into the spine. Arms can be reaching up overhead or they can come down to heart center. Right, and you notice here when you get still, right? Or maybe you wobble and your mind goes into overdrive. Can you quiet it? Can you find some stillness in the mind? Beautiful, take a breath in. Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Left hand stays down, right hand comes up. Low lunge twist for the second time. Beautiful, take a breath in. Right hand comes down. You step back to plank. Move through vinyasa or make your way back to downward facing dog. Take a breath in. Left leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it in between the hands, low lunge. Right, so watch that right ankle that doesn't kick out towards the right, like pull it back into center. Right? Just like you go to the center of yourself to find that stillness and knowing. Hug everything into the center line. Right hand stays down, left hand comes up, low lunge twist. Breathe. Take a breath in, left hand comes down to the mat. Inhale, you rise to high crescent lunge. Arms reach up overhead or they come to heart center. Keep bending into that left knee. Take a breath in, hands come down to the mat, right hand stays down, low lunge twist for the second time, left hand reaches up towards the ceiling. Beautiful, take a breath in, exhale, left hand comes down, you step back to plank, you pause, you take a breath in, exhale, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on an inhale. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. And in downward facing dog, you take three rounds of breath. Find some stillness. Meet the parts of yourself that you may not have had a conversation with today. And know that your body has got you. Beautiful, take a breath in, right leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it forward in between the hands. Low lunge, left hand stays down, right hand comes up, low lunge twist. You take a breath in, right hand comes down, inhale, you rise to high crescent lunge. This time the arms reach up overhead, interlace all but the index fingers, you got it. Maybe you look up, you lean back. Beautiful, take a breath in, unclasp the hands, hands come down to the mat, low lunge twist, right hand stays lifted. Beautiful, you take a breath in and a breath out. Listen up, this time the hands are gonna come down to the mat, left foot's gonna step up to meet the right, you're at the top of the mat. Halfway lift on an inhale, the spine is long. Reach the hands behind your back, broaden across the chest. Roll the shoulders on your back. Exhale, you fold. Right leg's gonna lift in the air behind you. On the exhale, you're gonna step it back so you're in a low lunge on the other side. Left knee stacked over the left ankle. You got it, low lunge twist. Right hand stays down, left hand lifts up. Open up across the chest. Take a breath in, hands come down to the mat. Inhale, you rise to high crescent lunge. Arms reach up overhead, interlace all but the index finger. Charlie's Angels hands. Roll the shoulders back, broaden across the chest. Maybe you look up. Stay high on the ball of that right foot. Beautiful, take a breath in, unclasp your hands, low lunge twist, right hand comes down, left hand comes up. Take a breath in, left hand comes down, right foot steps up to meet the left, halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you plant your hands, you move through vinyasa, or just make your way back to downward facing dog. Right, so part of this practice is practicing tuning in to what's speaking to you in that quiet place, the quiet place that you sink into. Right, that deep place of knowing, and you move from that space. From downward facing dog, you take a breath in and a breath out. Right leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it forward in between your hands. Left hand stays down, low lunge twist, right hand lifts up. Beautiful, take a breath in. Exhale, right hand comes down. Inhale, you rise to standing. Charlie's Angels fingers. Look up, lean back, shoulders fall away from the ears. So this time you're gonna unclasp your hands, arms reach up overhead. On an exhale, you're gonna open it up, warrior two. So the right knee is stacked over the right ankle. You're gonna spin the left foot down. Your back edge of that left foot is sealed against the mat. Shoulders are moving away from your ears. Hip points are facing the side of the mat. Arms are strong. It's a big, powerful pose. And you breathe and you notice here and you get curious about what comes up. It's a new pose, like it's something that we haven't done yet. Is there an urge to move when you're challenged or you don't know or you're uncertain? Right, those are the times that we need to sink in and get quiet and get still. You're going to flip the front palm and you're going to reach back, peaceful warrior. You're going to spin the back foot down, hands are going to come down to the mat and you're in a low lunge. Right, so the right knee stacked over the right ankle, left hand stays down, right hand comes up, low lunge twist. Right, so you can stay here or you can move into side plank. So if you're in side plank, you're going to roll to the outside edge of the left foot. Left hand is stacked underneath the nose towards the center of the mat. Right hand's going to lift up. And you breathe, the hips are lifting up towards the ceiling, right? And you trust. Take a breath in, right hand's gonna come down to the mat. If you're in a low lunge, you're gonna unwind. If you're in side plank, you're gonna push back to downward facing dog. You take a full breath in and a long breath out. Left leg lifts to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you step it in between your hands. Right hand stays down, left hand lifts up, low lunge twist. Take a breath in, left hand comes down. On the inhale, you're gonna rise to high crescent lunge. Interlace all but the index fingers. Drop the shoulders, look up, lean back. Take a breath in, unclasp the hands. You're gonna spin the back foot down, open it up to warrior two. So feel expansion across your chest. Take up space on the mat, right? And settle in here. Can you smooth out the breath? Can you smooth out the mind? Can you be still and know that even though your legs are shaking, you're okay, you're fine. You breathe, you flip the front palm, you reach back, peaceful warrior. Exhale, you're gonna cartwheel your hands to frame the left foot. You're gonna send the back, the right toes so that you're in a low lunge. Right hand stays down, left hand comes up. You can stay here, you can move into side plank by rolling to the outside edge of the right foot. Stack the left foot on top, left hand lifts up. Really press down into the right hand, spread the fingers, lift the hips. You breathe in and you breathe out. Take a breath in, exhale, the left hand comes down to the mat no matter where you are. You step back to plank. And you take five full rounds of breath in plank. And you notice here. How can you find stillness? How can you sink deeper into yourself in this pose? And maybe you say, there's no way that's ever happening, but where can you find the strength, right? When you finish that fifth breath, you're gonna make your way back to downward facing dog. You're going to take a breath in and a breath out. You're going to walk your hands back to your feet. Feet are going to go wide to the edges of the mat, and you're going to grab opposite elbows and come into ragdoll. Right, so in ragdoll, you let your head and neck release. Let gravity pull your head towards the mat. Maybe you have some movement, maybe you have stillness. But can you sink into that place of knowing, into the breath, into the heart space? That no matter what's going on in your house, the dog's barking, you know, somebody's saying mom, somebody wants to know what's for dinner, like, can you find that quiet? Take a breath in and a breath out. Fingertips come down to the mat. Left hand stays down, right hand lifts up. You twist open. Maybe you bend into that left knee. Take a breath in, right hand comes down, left hand lifts up, open up to the left. Take a breath in and a breath out. Left hand comes down to the mat. You toe heel your feet back to hip distance. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold. You're gonna walk your hands back out to plank. You're gonna pause. You're gonna take a breath in and a breath out. Your next exhale, you're gonna lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on an inhale. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. Take a breath in and a breath out. You look forward, you walk, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale, exhale, you fold. You're gonna ground down into the left foot. Right foot's gonna lift as you rise to standing. Arms reach up overhead, Charlie's Angels hands, right? So the knee is stacked over the right ankle. The right foot is flexed. You hug the belly button into the core. Right, that left leg is strong. You're grounding down into all four corners of the left foot, pulling up through the left thigh bone. Unhinge your jaw. You breathe. You notice. You wobble. Where do you find stillness and movement? You take a breath in. Exhale, you're gonna unclasp your hands. They're gonna come down to the mat, standing splits. So in standing splits, the heart's reaching forward in between your arms, crown of the head's reaching towards the front of the room. Take a breath in. Right foot meets the left at the top of the mat. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Left leg lifts as you rise to standing. Arms reach up overhead. Clasp all but the index finger. Different side, different sensation, different opportunity to find stillness, to find a knowing, to find a trust, right? That knowing is really a trust, like that intuition. And how often do you hear your intuition and you don't trust it? Right? This is the practice of getting to know it. Getting still and quiet allows us to get to know that voice. Take a breath in, unclasp the hands. Hands come down to the mat, standing splits. Flex the back foot. You want the hip point square to the mat. Maybe you have to bend that right leg a little bit to make that happen. You take a breath in and a breath out. Left foot meets the right. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Right leg lifts as you rise to standing. Right? Arms reach up overhead, interlace all but the index fingers. Take a breath in. From here, you're gonna move into warrior three. So the right leg is gonna kick back straight out behind you. Arms are reaching forward. Spine is long. Beautiful. You take a breath in and a breath out. On your exhale, right toes are gonna touch down at the back of the mat. Your hands are still in Charlie's Angels arms and you're gonna rise up strong to standing. High crescent lunge. Left knee stacked over the left ankle. Beautiful, take a breath in, unclasp the hands, open it up, warrior two. You spin the back foot down. Bend into that left knee. Flip the front palm, reach back, peaceful warrior, and then you're gonna come into side angle pose. So the left forearm is gonna be on the left thigh, but can you hover it there? Right, trust that your core and your legs have you. Know that they're not gonna let you fall. Right arm is reaching up overhead. Beautiful, take a breath in. You come back to warrior two. You flip the front palm, you reach back, peaceful warrior. Then you cartwheel your hands to the mat and move through vinyasa. you take a breath in and a breath out. You look forward, walk, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. You ground down into the right foot. Left foot lifts as you rise to standing. Arms reach up overhead. Interlace all but the index fingers. Take a breath in. You're going to move into warrior three. So the left knee moves through standing and it's going to reach out behind you. Arms are reaching forward. Really flex that left foot as if you want to put your footprint on the back wall. Maybe you shake, maybe you wobble. You take a breath in, the left foot's gonna touch down on the at the back of the mat. On the exhale, you're gonna rise up to high crescent lunge. Yep, fingertips are still interlaced. Beautiful, can you soften the shoulders? Can you smooth out the breath? Take a breath in, you're gonna unclasp the hands. Exhale, you're gonna open it up where you're two. Right knee stacked over the right ankle. Right, that left thigh is parallel to the mat. Soften the shoulders, unhinge the jaw. You're gonna flip the front palm, you're gonna reach back, peaceful warrior, and you're gonna come into side angle pose on this side. So again, your hand can come down to the mat, it can come to a block. Or you can hover that right forearm over the right thigh. Don't dump all of your body weight and feel this incredible lift on the left side body as the left arm reaches up towards the ceiling. Keep bending into the right knee. The right knee likes to get lazy and cave in. Can you bring it out over towards the right pinky toe? And you sink in. You sink in to the place where you only hear your breath, not the voices in your head, not the voices that tell you that your legs are tired, you can't do this, you need to take a break. Right, the body is stronger than the mind. You're gonna come back to warrior two on an inhale. You're gonna flip the front palm, reach back, peaceful warrior. You're gonna cartwheel your hands to the mat and move through vinyasa. And downward facing dog, you're gonna take a breath in and a breath out. Your next inhale, you're gonna walk, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Ground down into the left foot. Right foot lifts up, arms reach up overhead. Interlace the fingers. Take a breath in. You're going to move into warrior three. That's strong in that left leg. Right foot is flexed. You're going to unclasp your hands and you're going to move in to half moon. So the left hand can come down to the mat. It can come to a block. You're going to open up. Flex the right foot. Right hand is lifting as if there's a string pulling you up. You can hover left hand. If you practice with me regularly, you know this is my favorite pose. There is a calmness and a stillness that comes over me even though I'm wobbling. You also know that I practiced this in my shower when I was learning this pose. I figured if I could do it in my shower, I could do it anywhere. You take a breath in. You're gonna come to standing splits at the top of the mat. Right foot still lifted. Take a breath in. Right foot meets the left at the top of the mat. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Left leg lifts as you rise to standing. Interlace all but the index fingers. You got it. Take a breath in. Left foot moves into warrior three. unclasp the fingers. Right hand's gonna come down to the mat. Open up to half moon. Left hand lifts. Great, if you're at home and you have a wall that doesn't have anything hanging on it, you can always practice on the wall. I would recommend that versus the shower. Beautiful, and you breathe, right? This is a challenging pose, and you notice what comes up when you're challenged. Can you find stillness in the mind? Take a breath in. On the exhale, you come to standing splits at the top of the mat, left leg's lifted. Take a breath in. Exhale, left foot meets the right. Halfway lift on an inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, you rise to standing. Exhale, you fold forward. One more inhale to a halfway lift. Exhale, you fold, you plant your hands, you step back to plank and you pause. You take a full breath in. Exhale, you lower down. Halfway lift to cobra. Exhale, you make your way back to downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, you're gonna take a breath in and a breath out. Right leg's gonna lift to the sky on an inhale. Exhale, you're gonna step it in between your hands. You're in a low lunge. And then you're gonna walk the right foot across the mat so that your right shin is parallel to the top of the mat. And you're gonna drop the back knee and come into pigeon. So you can stay lifted up on your hands, or you can walk your hands forward and fold over the right leg. Right, this is a hip opener. If you know that this doesn't work, you can always take half pigeon on your back. Right? And you get still here. Breathe and you notice. And when you get the urge to move, can you breathe in to calm and to quiet? I can know things down at this level that I can't on the chaotic surface. Down here, when I pose a question about my life in words or abstract images, I sense a nudge. The nudge guides me toward the next precise thing. And then, when I silently acknowledge the nudge, it fills me. The knowing feels like warm liquid gold filling my veins and solidifying just enough to make me feel steady and certain. Whenever uncertainty arises, I sink. I sink beneath the swirling surf of words, fear, expectations, conditioning, and advice, and feel for the knowing. Your fingertips back towards your shin. You're going to tuck the left toes and push back into a three-legged downward dog. Maybe you bend the knee, stack the hips, roll the hips open. Take a breath in, exhale, the right foot comes down to the mat. Take a full breath in and a long breath out. Left leg lifts to the sky on the inhale. Exhale, you step the foot in between the hands. You're in a low lunge. You're gonna walk the left foot across the top of the mat. Left shin is parallel to the mat. You're gonna untuck the toes, drop the right knee to the mat. come into pigeon on this side. So you can stay up on your hands or you can fold forward. Right, different side, different sensation. It just is. It doesn't mean anything. So if you start to go there, can you breathe in to knowing? It's just your body. Breathe in, you breathe out. And we carry a lot of stuff in our hips. And oftentimes for me, when I'm in a hip opener, I have this urge to run and move. And it takes great practice to sit with the stillness of it. To sink into that knowing. Back up to your hands. Walk your hands towards your shin. You're going to tuck the right toes. Make your way to a three-legged downward facing dog. You're going to bend the left knee, stack the hips, roll it open. Maybe you roll the ankle. And take a breath in and a breath out. Left foot comes down to the mat. Take an inhale, glide forward to high plank. And you pause here. Been here many times today. Know that you are strong. Take a breath in, exhale, you lower down. Heart lifts to cobra on an inhale, and you make your way to downward facing dog for the last time. Beautiful, you take a breath in and a breath out. You're gonna walk your feet through your hands and come down to your back. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a hug. Rock side to side. You're going to take your feet wide to the edges of the mat. You're going to drop your knees over towards the right. Maybe you take the right foot and place it on top of the left thigh. Feel the sensation on the left outer hip. Right, and as practice starts to wind down, and the physical practice gets still, the mind starts to get active, right? So can you find some stillness there? When you start to drift, you come back, you anchor in, you notice. You get curious about what comes up. Inhale, you come back to center with the knees. Exhale, you drop them over to the left. Left foot can come to the top of the right thigh if you would like. Tap into that space, you sink into that space. Some call it faith, some call it your inner voice, your intuition, whatever that is for you. Tap into that space and know that you're okay, know that this craziness is gonna end. Take a breath in, you come back to center. You're gonna hug the knees into the chest. You're gonna reach through the thighs, grab up, grab the outside edges of your feet and come into happy baby. So the spine is long on the mat, the knees are energetically pulling towards the armpits. And maybe you rock side to side. Release the grip on your feet. Right knee's gonna stay hugged in, left leg's gonna go long to the mat. You're gonna take the left hand to the outside of the right knee, cross it over your body. Spinal twist. Right arm can reach out to the side. You can look out over the left. Breath in, you come back to center, left knee comes in, left right leg goes out long, cross the left knee over the body. Take a breath in, you come back to center. Legs go straight up in the air. Arms can be by your side. You can put a block at the base of your sacrum, or you can put your hands underneath your back. With this final inversion, your feet can be flexed, they can point. Take a breath in and a breath out. You're gonna hug your knees into your chest one leg at a time. Wrap your arms around your shins. Give yourself a hug. And then the right leg is gonna go out long to the right corner of the mat. Left leg goes out long. Arms by your side. Make this final resting pose, Shavasana, to let the mind and body rest. Easier to let the body rest than the mind, but when you find yourself drifting, come back. Just notice. Come back to the stillness, come back to the knowing. Be still and know. Take a breath in and a breath out. Let the shoulders fall away from the ears. Let the body sink into the mat. Shavasana. to bring some attention back to your breath. Some movement into your fingers and your toes. Keeping your eyes closed, roll gently to your right side and pause. And when you're ready, keeping your eyes closed, help yourself gently up to seated at the top of your mat. Together on an inhale, arms reach up overhead. Exhale, hands come to heart center and pause. Be still and know that in this center space, there is a truth, there is an honesty, there is a knowing. Together, take a full breath in and a long breath out. The light and truth in me sees and honors that in each of you. Hope you have a wonderful day. This will be posted on the Balance YouTube page, and check it out for a lot of other classes with our awesome teaching staff. Have a great night. Namaste.